Hi, this is Brock Thoene. Today's subject is What Wise Men See, the Transit of Venus. Next Tuesday, June 5th, you will have the opportunity to observe something that won't occur again in your lifetime. The planet Venus will pass directly between the Earth and the Sun, so that Venus is silhouetted as a black dot creeping across the solar disk. The next time this event will be observable from Earth won't be until the year 2117. First, a warning. Never look directly at the Sun without proper eye protection, not sunglasses, but properly rated welding glass, or the equivalent. And never look at the Sun through unshielded binoculars or telescopes, because blindness may result. This celestial event will be observed by scientists around the globe and by satellites orbiting overhead for a variety of reasons. Chief among these is a study of the way Venus affects the light coming from the Sun. This information will aid in the discovery of exoplanets, planets circling stars other than our Sun. Ever since first observable by humans, transits have touched our understanding of the universe. It was the transit of Venus in 1769 that sent the English Captain Cook to the South Seas. Knowing the distance from Europe to Tahiti, and then observing Venus crossing the Sun, trigonometry was used to calculate the distance from the Earth to the Sun, a fact not known before that event. But the conjunction of the Sun, Shemesh, holy fire in Hebrew, and Venus, Noga, or splendor, should also affect our spiritual understanding of the universe as well. Try this. Venus is the third brightest object in Earth's sky after the Sun and Moon. It's so bright that it can be seen in daylight if you know where to look. It's so bright that it casts a shadow at night under the right conditions. But compared to the Sun, Venus is a mere black dot, barely a blemish. Remember, Venus only shines at all by reflecting the power of the Sun. Now, we often speak of Noga as the splendor of the Lord, and rightly so, since glory and splendor are among the characteristics of the God of the universe. But consider, for just a moment, Venus as representing the splendor of man. Not a man, but the combined achievements and famous undertakings of all humankind. Compared with the holy fire of God, what significance do human achievements have, apart from how they represent worship of or service to God? Venus does not contribute one drop to the power of sunlight. God rules the universe with such majesty and order that we can say, if the universe remains, there will be another transit in 2117 to be seen and marveled at by those who are then alive. But the achievements of those living then, added to our own, and summed up with all the ages that have gone before, will not challenge the grandeur of God. What does Isaiah 41:15 say? Behold, the nations are like a drop in the bucket and are counted as the small dust on the scales. In case you haven't seen a pan balance for measuring weight recently, that image means that all the achievements of all the nations are less than dust, which is too insignificant to even bother blowing off the scale. But thanks be to God, there is also this thought from Malachi 4:2. But to you who revere my name, says the Lord, the Sun of Righteousness will arise with healing in his wings. As you ponder the transit of Venus, will you let the Sun, S-O-N, of Righteousness, that is Jesus, come to you on wings of healing and mercy? Do you know this rhyme? Only one life, 'twill soon be past. Only what's done for Christ will last. As St. Paul says, "Therefore, my beloved, be firm, immovable, always abounding in the work of the Lord, knowing that your labor in the Lord is not in vain." Blessings in the name of Yeshua Messiah.